This is a Toroidal propeller, and this is me testing that same propeller while also being an idiot. Now, in order to test these propellers to the utmost degree, I decided to use a TinyWhoop. I debated whether or not to use an enclosed prop TinyWhoop, like this one, but opted to go for an open prop TinyWhoop, such as this 1S Flywoo Firefly Nano Baby. Wow. Quick run over on the advantages of a Toroidal propeller, as I'm sure some of you are already very familiar with them. The main advantage is that they tend to be slightly quieter than traditional designs, as the noise levels between the 1 to 5 kHz range are reduced. They have a boost in efficiency at certain RPM ranges. Now, for the purposes of this project, I definitely don't expect to see any gains in efficiency, as these props are printed on an FDM printer, which will inevitably introduce deformities into the propeller. And I'm also positive that my designs are far from optimized, but I think it'd be interesting to see if we're able to notice any difference in prop noise slash pitch. Also, if you want to download and print a set of these props for your own use, there will be a Thingiverse link below where you can download them. Now, I've come up with three individual tests. One that will test sound slash pitch, one for battery life, and one for flight characteristics. Test number one will have the drone in two configurations, one with the Toroidal propeller on it, and the other with the traditional two-bladed prop on it. We'll then take the drone and use double-sided sticky tape to go ahead and stick it directly to the desk. From there, we'll go ahead and turn the drone on at idle for both prop configurations and measure the sound levels for each, and then compare. And then we'll go ahead and raise the throttle max and do the same. For test number two, we'll have the drone in each configuration hover for as long as possible, and this will allow us to measure battery life. For test number three, we'll have the drone in each configuration do laps. That way we can go ahead and test controllability and flight characteristics, such as full throttle punch outs. Now, the designing that went into this prop was far from a first try success. In fact, I went through a lot of renditions, and I mean a lot. In total, I made over 8 different designs, some of which were two-bladed designs, which are far more common, and is where I found my first success. I then tried making it really fancy by making the props have a traditional airfoil shape, which ended up just being a total nightmare to 3D print. So I scrapped that and went back to the saying, keep it simple, stupid, by making the walls the same thickness throughout and not varying the arch of the blade, which made for much smoother 3D printing, as well as better performance. I then reapplied that concept to a three-bladed design, which ended up having the best performance overall, which still wasn't great performance, but hey. It looked really cool, and to be honest, this is half the purpose of this project. I mean, who doesn't want a set of Toroidal props for their TinyWhoop?
Now, I used SolidWorks to design all of these, which was definitely a learning experience, as I had never designed a propeller-like shape before. But with a couple YouTube tutorials under my belt, I was able to figure it out pretty quickly and started 3D printing prototypes.
Some key takeaways if you plan to print your own are to make sure to print them with the smallest layer height your printer is capable of. I printed these with 0.1mm layer height and a nozzle temp of 210 degrees with a raft in place as well. I'm also using a 0.4mm nozzle end. To minimize bubbles in the print, I use newer filament. I'm positive that if you had an SLA or resin 3D printer, you would be able to see significant increases in efficiency and noise levels, but alas, that remains for a future video. Once I had the prints, I took a pocket knife and just scraped over any bumps that had formed, as well as sanded some spots, which took a while until I was satisfied. Fair warning to any of you who do print a set for your drone, there's a little bit of work to do. I was then able to pop the propellers right onto the motor shafts without too much hassle. Alright, for test number one, I'm just going to let the drones do the buzzing, and there'll be a sound meter next to each test that'll indicate the decibel levels. Alright, so it was pretty clear to see that the traditional propellers were significantly quieter at lower RPM, but at higher RPM, the Toroidal propellers were just slightly quieter, and they definitely had a different noise, more of a whooshing sound. For test 2, we're just going to be hovering for as long as possible to test battery life. We'll do this in each configuration. I'm running a 660 milliamp battery for this test. The traditional prop scored a time of 450-ish, and now we're going to go ahead and see what the Toroidal props can do. Alright, test 2 was a big L for the Toroidal propeller. We lost 3 minutes of flight time, so we're just going to go ahead and jump right into test number 3 and see how the flight characteristics are. These are the traditional props, and as you can see, we're using about 4.3 amps on average as we fly around. Handling is good, it's normal, so the real question is, how are these Toroidal props going to do? And as you can see, wow, yeah, we're even in the ground effect here, and we're using about 8 amps just flying around, and then when I do a full throttle punch out, it jumps up to about 10 amps. So
Yeah, I'm just going to say that these are not practical at all, but they sure are cool.
I took away a lot from this project, such as SolidWorks skills that I had never used before. It was also extremely satisfying to 3D print propellers, much less Toroidal propellers, and then see your drone fly around with them. I of course didn't even come close to matching the efficiency of the traditional impellers, and that is in no part a reflection of the potential that Toroidal propellers have, but rather one in how far you can go with an FDM printer, as well as my own shortcomings as a propeller designer. Regardless, I hope you enjoyed the process, and thank you so much for watching.